Alright guys, time to talk about foot trading. It is your time now to join the dozens of new members we get every single week learning how to trade on the FIFA market. You might be thinking to yourself, well, FIFA's coming towards an end. Now is the perfect time to trade. It's when the market is the most consistent, there's not too much jumping up and down, and it allows you to basically focus on how the market goes up and down and up and down, and you're able to then make a lot of coins very quickly. You can then use the knowledge you've gained now to apply that to FIFA 23 and gain yourself a massive head start on everyone else when you're able to build the best teams on the game. So check out the website, but for now, let's get into the video. Yo, what is up guys? Welcome back to a brand new video with me, Fuzzball40. Make sure you subscribe if you're new around here. Thank you to everyone recently. There's been so many new subscribers to the channel. I'm loving seeing your comments, all that sort of stuff, telling me how you're enjoying the game still. If you do comment down below, I always try and get back to you, try and sort of message back as many times as I possibly can to you guys, whether it's a question, just a statement, whatever it is. Make sure you like the video as well. It massively helps us to get recommended to more and more people. A couple of bits of housekeeping though to start with. The first is, if you guys did what I said to do the other day and invested in stuff that was going out of packs, you would have done brilliantly well. Kroos is at about 33k now. I paid 23 for these ones that I've got. And Sergio Busquets is at about 23, 24k. I paid about 16 to 16.5. It was a really easy call, so well done if you got involved. You would have made thousands and thousands and thousands of coins, which is great. But we're here to talk about crafting more picks and packs and all that sort of stuff. And I've seen so many people say that this SBC here, the Common Gold Triple, is pointless. And truly, it is not. It's a superb SBC if you use it in the right way. So, requirements. For the triple gold upgrade, literally 6 bronze cards for 3 common golds, okay? 6 bronze cards. Now, I want to just put this in perspective for you guys. Normally, for 3 common golds, you need to put about 55 bronzes into the upgrades to silvers, and then you need to take those silvers you get from those upgrades and put them into the 3 common gold, right? So you're looking at 55 bronzes and 11 silvers gets you 3 common golds. It's now 6. Literally, 6 bronzes gets you 3 common golds. Now, what I've seen people complain, because the first thing is, this 75 times 5 requires rares. Now, it can require gold rares or silver rares. There's not much difference in price between them now, so it doesn't really matter. And everyone's like, well, it only gives you commons. This is true. Then here, I see people complain about it in relation to the 82 plus pick, because you need 6 rares for this. What people don't realise is other upgrades exist on this game, and there are ways you can utilise this common gold upgrade to do bits, okay? So the first thing that you might want to think about doing is choosing a couple of these league SBCs. So you guys know I'm loving the Serie A at the moment. It's one of my favourites. But rare silver Serie A players might be a bit expensive, so you might want to choose a different one. But what you're looking to choose is one that's decently gold heavy. La Liga Santander can be fantastic for that. CSL's got quite a few gold cards in it. In my opinion, I choose a major and a minor. The major, if I can give you any advice, would be the Serie A. That's the one I would go for. And the reason for that is the Serie A does not require silvers until you get to the last squad. And they haven't even got to be rare. So you can work with any type of gold for these three here. So it doesn't make a difference. So what you're essentially going to do is you're going to take yourself over to the favourites. You're going to put it anyway. And you're going to put your golds in your bronzes into this gold pack, okay? You're going to get 3 common golds. Anytime you hit a league SBC card of your league, you'll hold on to that. So whether it's Serie A, whether it's Chinese Super League, I'd probably do like a minor league and a major league probably. You're going to keep all that stuff there basically and keep hold of those cards. Once you've done that, you've got some common golds left over, okay? So you can put some to the side for the 82 plus player pick, no problem. This is perfectly fine to stick them into this right now. That's where I would put mine to a degree. And then some of them can be taken away from the common gold triple upgrade and can go into the standard, because there is still the standard upgrade for silver golds into gold, so common golds into rare golds. So I've worked it out basically that 24 bronzes now gets you 2 rare golds. Okay, so 24 bronzes. So you can go and buy those bronzes if you want, your choice. What I would do, as always, is bronze pack method. That's how I would get my bronzes in about an hour. You could probably get yourself a few hundred. It's not hard. We've got this thing here basically. We've got Ginter here, but behind there basically is the gold and silver and bronze packs. Classic bronze pack, open them up, sell everything that sells, keep all the players that don't, and the players that don't go into that triple common upgrade. It's really, really easy, okay? So you're going to go and put them into that, and that will give you, 24 bronzes give you 2 rare golds. You need essentially 6 for this, so open up packs for maybe an hour, 2 hours, and you'll probably get enough for a fair amount of picks, probably talking something in the region of about 10 to 20 picks, basically, that easy. But I probably would be mindful of the better way to do this is these common goals that you get from the League SBC specifically are going to really speed it up, okay? So let's say you're getting Serie A goals and you're going to put it into this first one. That gives you a Jumbo Premium Goal Pack. That's going to give you not far off what you need for a pick if you want it, or the rares can go into a 75x5. Again, small prime mixed players pack, any rares can go into that. Premium gold pack, anything can go into that. And the small prime silver pack, anything here that is tradable, sell. Sell this stuff because it will give you coins back and you won't make any losses. You'll make profit, if anything, from making these packs. At the end of the Serie A, you're going to get a prime gold players pack. That's going to give you already half of what you need for 75x5. So really, by completing the Serie A, which is going to be relatively easy, by completing the Serie A, you're also going to get yourself a 75x5, potentially part of an 82 pick as well if you want it, plus a chance to pack anything else you get from here, which is nuts, and tradable cards that you can then sell. Anything from Serie A you would keep, of course, but now you need 7 bronze or silver players, so people will say, right, they're expensive right now. They're not as bad as you think if you bid on them, okay? So right now, yes, it's true that if you go to silver rare Serie A, right now, they're like 1,200 plus, okay? They're expensive because silver rares are all expensive. However, if you go silvers, not silver rare, silver, they're not as expensive. You can pick them up at like 500 to 600 coins relatively consistently. I don't know about bronzes at the moment. Again, not much different. You can get those cheap. And moreover, you can get them really cheap if you decide to go and throw bids on them. Again, this has got a minute left. This guy's got like next to no time on him. You can just go and pick them up from here and bid on them, and you can use these for the final Serie A squad. Now, I know you do need rares for the other squad, but you will get them naturally just by doing the upgrades. So basically, you might go, right, I'm going to do a couple of squads. When you convert all your stuff up, right, so when you take your golds, you take your bronzes, put them into the golds. When you take your golds here and put them into this upgrade here, you've got that upgrade. You can keep your Serie A rares because you're going to use them. Everything else can be used to go into the 75x5 or the player pick. So really, you've got two choices here, and it is quite simple. Open up bronze packs no matter what you do. It's just a standard thing you should always be doing on this game. Or if you really want to go and do it cheaper, then sort of bronze packs will give you it for free. If you're happy to spend some coins, just go and buy golds. Just go and buy bronzes even. Go into the common gold triple upgrades. You don't have a choice. You can just convert it all up if you really want to. Convert it into the gold upgrade, put those into the 75x5, put those into the 80+, 82+ player pick. You're perfectly fine to do that. And it's the easiest way to do things. Just take this into gold upgrade. And think about it this way, right? So if, basically, the 24 bronzes gives you a gold upgrade, for something in the region of about 100 bronzes, which I can get in about half an hour of opening up bronze packs, it's pretty easy, doesn't take long at all, you get yourself a 75x5. That's very good fodder you're getting very quickly. Anything crap goes back into this upgrade. So anything that's not of decent sort of level, if it's just a crap gold rare, goes back into this pack, and that will speed up your next pack. However, what I would prefer to do is not to just do that. I'd also like to do League SBC along the way. I'll be keeping my Serie A, probably keeping the CSL as well, because it's quite a bronze heavy league as well. So when I'm opening up the bronze packs, I'll get quite a few of the CSL cards from that as well. That's the two that I'll do. I'll be opening those packs up, using the stuff from those packs into these upgrades. Anything tradable gets sold to give you my coins back, if not, make profit. And I'll repeat that process and repeat that process. I'll be doing this all live on stream. You'll be able to see what I'm doing, grind along with me, and it is so, so easy to do. Everyone says that this SBC was pointless, and all you had to do was look beyond the content that was directly in front of you, which is 86 plus picks. Well, what's that for? The one that needs rares, it needs rares. Everyone's like, it has no use whatsoever. It does. If you use what else was on the game, it's very rare that EA bring out something that has no use whatsoever. You've just got to look for your use. If you're new around here, make sure you subscribe down below. Make sure your notifications are turned on so you never miss an upload. Make sure you subscribe. Over half of you that watch the videos aren't subscribed. But for now, I'm out. Peace out. I'll speak to you soon.